Hi there. Okay, so here's our next video. This is on dilation. Now, this is introductory dilation. It's the fourth type of transformation after translation, reflection, rotation. Anyway, what a dilation is, you can see these pictures here. We got something getting bigger and then something bigger getting smaller, but it's the same shape. Okay, a dilation is exactly that. It's when something gets bigger or smaller. Now, what you could do to see that is, if you were to go into a bathroom by the mirror and look in the mirror and cover your eyes after the lights have been on, keep the lights on, and then remove your fingers, remove your hands from your eyes, you'll see your pupils go from bigger to smaller as the light, it adjusts to the light. That's an example of dilation by a certain type of factor, okay? Likewise, if it was light out and then it suddenly became dark out, your pupils would go from small to bigger. That's another example of dilation, okay? So there's two ways to really look at it here. Well, it's one way, which is the opposite from each other. So small to big, this is called a dilation. You want to write this down, okay? Dilation by a factor greater than 1. Okay? Greater than 1 means it's a number, like if you were to multiply something, if you were to multiply this by a factor greater than 1, you get something that is bigger than what you started with. Simple as that. Likewise, going from bigger to smaller is called a dilation by a factor less than 1. Okay? So when you go from bigger to smaller, if you had something and you multiplied it by something that's less than 1 whole, you're going to end up with something smaller. I mean, that's pretty simple, but make sure you just put this down in your notes here just to kind of get an idea. Okay? So that's really all dilation is. There's nothing to be afraid of or anything like that. But we're going to be looking at how it shows up on a graph. Okay? Now this might be the scary thing. Don't let it scare you. Suppose you're given a shape on a graph and it says dilate it or show a dilated version or whatever. You just need to know what we're talking about here. Okay? A dilated version of this wouldn't necessarily be something like this. You know, although it would make a bigger triangle, yes, the same shape, because being the same shape is part of this here. But it could be something that looks like this, and I'll explain in a second why. Okay, like we moved all the points. Oh, how do we figure this out? What happened? Well, looking at the graph, I'm going to draw some perspective lines here, because math is beautiful art anyway. If we do this, it should look like maybe like in the background you have this little triangle and in the upper foreground you have this bigger triangle. So, just for a perspective to see it, but what this is a dilation. This triangle, we applied a dilation by a factor greater than 1 to make it larger. Likewise, if we wanted to go from this triangle to this tiny one, we would apply a dilation of a factor less than 1 to get us down to this one, to shrink it. Okay, pretty straightforward. I mean, just because it's on a graph, don't let that freak you out, okay? Easy as pie, as long as you understand this, okay? But I'm going to show a couple examples in the next video with points, but this one I'm just going to show you like with general shapes what we're talking about here, okay? If I said dilate this rectangle by a factor of 3, I'm tripling it, okay? I'm tripling it in size, okay? So just imagine a rectangle like this with some, I mean, it would be something like that, but how do we know how big it is? Well, if this was 6 and that's 3, 6 and 3, if we triple that, we now are doing 3 times 3, we're tripling the 6, we're tripling the 3, we're tripling the 6, so the new dimensions of the dilated rectangle are 18 units by 9 units, okay? So this rectangle has been dilated by a factor of 3 from this origination point. Likewise, to go backwards, you would dilate this by a factor of 1/3, because if we were to multiply this by 1/3, we would get what we started with, six, three, okay? Anyway, and I was just gonna show that with the other example here. If we were to, for example, dilate by factor of 1/2, for example, I bet you already know what the answer is. If this triangle was originally 6 and 6 and 6, well, once we apply the transformation of a dilation by a factor of 1/2, we're going to end up with a triangle that's got the distances that are half as long, 3, 3, and 3. So this has been dilated by a factor of 1/2, and that's what we end up with. So it's really quite simple. Next video, I'll show you how it works with a graph with points.